yourself. As other people see you and you'll be yourself. Don't pretend that you're what you're not. You're terrific with what you've got. So be yourself and the whole wide world is...
Very special holiday in the Lennon family.
Like everything else a large family does, we celebrate Halloween in a big way. We completely decorate the outside of Mom's house and do four shows in an evening, written and performed by various members of the Lennon family.
Everyone is encouraged to do his own thing, and sometimes it gets very wild, sort of like it was on the Welk show. You never knew what would happen when you told the gang to just be yourself.
Be yourself, and the whole...
Good evening, my friends. Glad you could come to our Halloween party. Our boys and girls have hinted that it's a good idea to be yourself, but I have a feeling that this is one night when they wouldn't follow their own advice. For example, here's one of your old friends, Larry Hooper, masquerading as a pirate.
This old house once knew my children. This old house once knew my wife. This old house was home and comfort as we fought the storms of life. This old house once rang with laughter. This old house heard many shouts. Now she trembles in the darkness when the lightning walks about. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the saints. This old house is a-getting shaky. This old house is a-getting old. This old house lets in the rain. This old house lets in the cold. On my knees I'm a-getting chilly, but I feel no fear nor pain. Cause I see an angel peeking through a broken window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the saints. This old house is afraid of thunder. This old house is afraid of storms. This old house just groans and trembles when the night wind flings its arms. This old house is a-getting feeble. This old house is a-needin' paint. Just like me, it's tuckered out, but I'm a-getting ready to meet the saints. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to oil the hinges, nor to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm a-getting ready to meet the saints.
Thank you.
The next song is really unbelievable, Jan. You and I and Peg are joined by our little sisters, Mimi and Annie, who are just 10 and 6 years old. We always had one or two Lennon sisters waiting in the wings when we needed them.
That's for sure. We were really lucky to have Mimi around. She's incredibly talented and a really fast study. She took Peggy's place once at Caesar's Palace on a month's notice. She worked with us quite a bit.
Now here's Mimi with daughter Mary, husband Dan, and her daughter Beth on her first communion day. Here's Beth in a Cleopatra costume we created together. These days, Mimi teaches pre-kindergarten at St. Mark's in Venice, where we all went to school.
Annie is the next to the youngest in our family, and as you'll see in the number, was amazingly confident at such a young age. At the age of 4, she could do a great imitation of Al Jolson and even did it once on one of our shows.
Annie has 2 children now, Christopher and Emily. Here they are, all dressed up for Halloween. Annie does the office work for her husband, Mike, who manages a summer camp. As precocious as she was, she chose not to go into show business, and she blames it on this number. We forgot to tell her to stand still after she took her bow. So, of course, she turned around, picked up her mask, and then was so embarrassed. Annie hated making that mistake, and she talked about it for years.
Those little girl ghosts are about to appear. I can feel it in my bones, my dry bones.
Sounds like a song cue to me.
Skeletons were Mimi and Annie Lennon. It looks like we're in for a lot of fun this evening. Joanne Cass is really a fun-loving girl, so she's right in character with her costume for the party. Okay, Joanne, here is your chance to clown it up.
Remember the old blooper shows? Bloopers were those funny mistakes that people made on radio and television. Mr. Welk was well known for them. But what you're about to see is not one of his.
This is a blooper made by the cameraman and the director. And it gave us a good laugh when we saw the show. Watch what happens after Mr. Welk introduces Norma.
Now, thank you. A very charming lady who is certainly not in character. Believe it or not, this is Norma Zimmer singing 3 o'clock in the morning.
It's 3 o'clock in the morning. We dance the whole night through, and daylight soon will be dawning. Just one more waltz with you. That melody so entrancing seems to be made for us two. I could just keep right on dancing forever, dear, with you.
Halloween. I can even make an orchestra appear right in the middle of a haunted house. Watch.
Oh, that's all right.
Did you say something?
I said, oh, that's all right. Don't be afraid. I won't hurt you, little girl.
Oh, I'm not afraid. whenever I feel afraid, I hold my head erect and whistle a happy tune, so no one will suspect I'm afraid.
While shivering in my shoes, I strike a happy pose and whistle a happy tune, and no one even knows I'm afraid. The result of this deception is very strange to tell, for when we fool the people we fear, we fool ourselves as well. We whistle a happy tune, and every single time, the happiness of the tune convinces us that we're not afraid.
Make believe you're brave, and the trick will take you far.
You may be as brave as you make believe you are. You may be as brave as you make believe you are.
Thank you, Janet. Thank you, Janet Lennon and Sir Aladdin. As you can see, when we put Aladdin into a suit of armor, it seems to come out armor ham.
Mr. Welk loved it when he had a good joke on someone. He would get a bad little boy look in his eye and try to keep from laughing. I loved watching you and Aladdin too, Jan. It brings back such fun memories.
Our Halloween memories go back a long way. Dad always put a few scary things on our front porch, and then he would dress in his old bathrobe and a wig and trick-or-treat the kids who came to our door before they could even get the words out of their mouths.
After Dad died in 1969, we decided to keep the tradition going, and it just grew from year to year. What started with a few things on the porch has become the total decoration of a large Victorian house.
Our family home has become known in town as the Halloween house. We completely change its appearance. We tie broken shutters on all the windows and hang dummies out of them. There are spiders and webs everywhere, and spooky old portraits peeking out of attic windows.
We create a cemetery in the front yard with all kinds of robots, statues, and skeletons to frighten the faint-hearted. You walk into the yard through the huge mouth of a clown face. The porch, of course, has a monster or two on it, greeting the visitors that come and go all evening.
We put an old pump organ on the balcony, and the Phantom of the Opera makes an appearance every hour or so. It's almost as if I can hear him now.
Thank you, Bob. You look very distinguished in that outfit. That young man even has talent in his feet. Ghosts don't spend all their time haunting old houses. Here are a few who seem to enjoy the wide open spaces. Dick Dale and the Lennon sisters, Peggy, who is now Mrs. Dick Cathcart, Kathy, and little Janet.
Yippee-yay.
Cowpoke went riding out one dark and windy day. Upon a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw, a-plowing through the ragged skies and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns was black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky, for he saw the riders coming hard, and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yi-yay!
Yippee-yi-yay!
The ghost rider's in the sky.
In the sky!
Faces gaunt, their eyes were blurred, and shirts all soaked with sweat. They're riding hard to catch that herd, but they ain't caught 'em yet. 'Cause they gotta ride forever on that range up in the sky, on horses snorting fire. As they ride on, hear their cry. Yippee-yi-yay!
Of our Halloween party. Let's meet Bob Duncan, Steve Smith, Craig Dixon, and Johnny Johnson.
Holy Oleanna, holy Oleanna, holy, 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 holy Oleanna.
Climbing up the Matterhorn, all alone as I could be, I reached the top, I paused to stop, I heard this mystic melody.
Holy Oleanna, holy Oleanna, holy, 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 holy Oleanna.
While rocketing one day in space, I found myself upon the moon. An ectoplasm greeted me.
Have you heard the latest tune?
Oleanna, holy Oleanna. Holy, 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 Oleanna.
I was tramping through the Congo when the savage tribe appeared, and their native chant was haunting just the sound that I had feared.
Oleanna, holy, Oleanna, holy, 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 Oleanna.
My ship was sinking in the water, so I sent an SOS. As I waited for an answer, you don't even have to guess.
Came a voice so calm and cheerful, just as cheerful as can be.
According to our latest survey, now the song is number 3.
Yay! Yay! Oleanna, Oleanna, holy, 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 Oleanna, Oleanna.
The Blenders were just like brothers to us on the show, always kidding around and getting in trouble. Our own brothers were even worse, and our Halloween celebrations give them the perfect excuse to be as crazy as they want.
It's our brother Bill who is the creative force behind our Halloween performances. Every year he does pretty much the same skit. This is the plot. Dr. Insano, also known as our brother Dan, invents a special potion that makes some kind of monster come alive or grow very large.
It's the same some kind of monster that changes from year to year. And many times it comes over the roof very dramatically. The first year it was King Kong. We had to use 8 sheets dyed dark brown for that one.
One year it was a spider, almost as big as the house. And once it was an alien, every bit as gruesome as the one that Sigourney Weaver had to battle.
Robots, mummies, skeletons, you name it, and Dr. Insano has brought it to life.
Whatever it is, it has to be sturdy enough to make it over the roof or up the side of the house or over the balcony 4 times. It's usually touch and go on the last performance.
Did we ever have a devil come to life, Jan?
Probably so, but never as cute as the one Mr. Welk is about to introduce.
On with the party, and we meet Arthur Duncan in the role of the man from down under. To the band, and we feature a guest trumpet player, Jim Porter. Jim is 23 years of age, a student at the University of Southern California, and a very, very talented musician. Ladies and gentlemen, Jim Porter.
Thank you.
great? Isn't he great? Thank you. And that was USC's Jim Porter playing It's All in the Game. And don't you agree that SC has better trumpet players than Notre Dame? Ladies and gentlemen, Natalie Nevin seems lonesome this evening. Let's listen to her story.
All I want is a room somewhere, far away from the cold night air, with one enormous chair. Oh, wouldn't it be lovely? Lots of chocolate for me to eat, lots of coal making lots of heat, warm face, warm hands, warm feet. Oh, wouldn't it be lovely? Oh, so lovely, sitting out so bloomin', doodly still. I would never budge till spring crept over the windowsill. Someone's head resting on my knee, warm and tender as he can be, who takes good care of me. Oh, wouldn't it be lovely, lovely, lovely,
probably think that we spend about a week decorating Mom's house.
Wrong.
We do it all in one day. Of course, there are a lot of us on hand to make it happen.
There are the 11 children and 10 spouses and 15 nieces and nephews, usually with various girlfriends and boyfriends. We begin at 8 a.m. sharp and start dragging stuff out of the basement and out of the attic.
It's sort of a rite of passage when you're old enough to go down Grandma's scary basement stairs to get out the Halloween props. The cellar is dark, and all the spooky things are down there. Legs coming out of boxes, dummies hanging by the neck, ugly hands with claws waiting to grab you.
After we get all the stuff outside, we start the hammering, sawing, tying, and painting. A few years ago, the home show came out to watch us and put together a fast-action video of the setup.
Here's our house at 10 a.m., the day of Halloween. As you can see, nothing has been done, but the transformation is about to begin.
Something strange in the neighborhood. Who you gonna call? Something weird and it don't look good. Who you gonna call?
This is great. All families, everybody has their little job and everybody does it. It's really fun. Yeah, we really love it.
My sister Dee Dee is a kindergarten teacher, and so she knows what the kids want.
I'm in charge of the whole front porch, making it scary for the trick-or-treaters to come up and get their trick-or-treats and leave. And we like to give them one last scare before they leave. It's fun.
My brother Dan is in charge of assembling the clown's head above the walkway.
It'll be about a 10-foot-high clown here. We're in the process of making it. Actually, last year was the first time we made it. And this is where all the kids come through to get the candy. I have a big tunnel here and some spider webs hanging down. These are the lips that we were just bringing out here. It actually formed the doorway. So you're really going into the mouth of the clown to come into the house.
My brother Joe has the graveyard shift.
This is going to be a graveyard. Every year we do a big graveyard scene. We have the gravestones over here that we saved through the years. The skeletons we got, I'm a chiropractor, so I use my influence with my friends. And I teach at a chiropractic college, and so they lent us the skeletons for that.
It's 1 o'clock and we're ahead of schedule sort of this time for maybe the first time ever, and there's a lot of electronic work to do on the robots, and all the subtle stuff starts happening now, so it isn't something. It's a fine line between scary and stupid. Meanwhile, it's my sister Kathy's job to hang the devil.
Billy, can I hang him off the balcony?
You can, but just make sure it ain't too cute.
I just love it. Every year it's something new and it's exciting. Of course, it's a mess, but they clean it up tomorrow.
Okay, now it looks like we're almost done out here. It's a fine-looking graveyard. Yeah. Robots, we're almost done. So we're going to go in and hammer out the show, try to run through it a little bit, because we only got about a half hour, 45 minutes before dark sets in. So we still got lots to do.
I free the makers.
That's just the way we feel while we're doing it, too. We finish right about dusk and start to think about getting everyone into their costumes. Janet and I do the makeup, and here are some of the more exotic efforts. We're very big on green faces, as you can tell. Here's a wagon load of Lennons in full Halloween drag.
We get carried away with costumes, too. Monsters, a dashing pirate, and how about this clown and skeletal ballerina? Sometimes our costumes are almost as good as the ones Jack Immel and Joanne Castle are wearing in the next number.
When we spoke to Joanne Castle the other day, she reminded us that she wasn't wearing a wig on that show, that she teased her own hair way out to here.
There are two very familiar-looking hobos in that number, too.
Trick or treat!
Well, hello, girls!
Oh, excuse me. Sorry, wrong house.
What's your hurry? Come on in. Hey, look who we got here.
Oh! Two sweet little girls. You know, when we were your age, we used to go out trick-or-treating.
Hey, I bet you were pretty good, too.
Well, you know.
Yeah, we had a regular routine worked up when we knocked on somebody's door.
Yeah. Hey, you still remember it?
Well, yeah, I think so.
Well, show it to the girls.
Well, okay.
Oh, okay.
Trick or treat, trick or treat, trick or treat on Halloween. You better treat us right, or overnight your little white house turns green.
Trick or treat, trick or treat, our raising off a fuss. Now if you smart your part, we sound and sweet, you better be good to us. Now we can yell, ring your bell, keep you up the whole night through.
And if you want your gate to circulate, we can do that too.
Trick or treat, trick or treat, trick or treat on Halloween. You better latch on to the gag or else your nightmares will come true. Trick or treat, trick or treat, trick-or-treat on Halloween. You better treat us right, or overnight your
little white house turns green.
Each other.
Well, I guess Kathy and Janet will be looking for a different neighborhood to play trick or treat. Oh, my. Even our Irish tenor, Joe Feeney, is all dressed up tonight. It looks like the wearing of the green. That makes me about the only one who is not in costume. But I guess Halloween is really for the young. Come in, Joe, and sing one of your songs. London street singer all dressed up in his pearly buttons, Bob Leader, along with our Dixieland boys, and the song Cheepers Creepers. Gentlemen, take it away, all of it. One and two and
Cheepers Creepers, where'd you get those papers? Cheepers Creepers, where'd you get those signs? Gosh, oh, get up, how'd they get so lit up? Gosh, oh, get up, how'd they get that size? Oh, golly gee, when you turn those heaters on, woe is me, got to put my cheaters on. Cheepers Creepers, where'd you get those weepers? Oh, those weepers, how they hypnotize. When did you get those eyes? Let it be. Thank you.
creepers, where did you get those eyes? Gosh, oh, get up, how'd they get so lit up? Gosh, oh, get up, how'd they get that size? Golly gee, when you turn those heaters on, woe is me, got to put my cheaters on. Oh, creepers, creepers, where'd you get those peepers? All those weepers, how they hypnotize. Where did you get those eyes? Where'd you get those eyes?
Quite often it takes us a while to discover how much talent we have in our orchestra. For instance, Mel and Clark joined our band about 3.5 years ago, and we're just now finding out what a really fine clarinet player he is. We're going to ask Malin to play a song that was made so very, very popular by the great Artie Shaw. I'm sure this will remind you of Artie Shaw's sensational arrangement of Begin the Begin, featuring Malin Clark. A one and two and a...
Over 1,000 people come by our house every Halloween, and lots of friends and neighbors stop by for one of Mom's famous chocolate chip cookies.
The local police help us out a lot with the traffic, and we've never had an accident or a bit of trouble. It's always fun and a great night.
But of course, there's the next day.
Ooh.
We put everything away in one day, again starting at 8 a.m., even after a late night.
Why do we do these things to ourselves?
It must be that the Lennons really enjoy entertaining their friends and neighbors.
But most of all, we like to entertain ourselves, our own family, right, Kat?
Right, Jan. You know, I think we better start resting up for next October 31st. So with a little bit of help from Norma Zimmer and Jim Roberts, we'll just say, Happy Halloween!
Good night, sweetheart. Till we meet tomorrow, good night, sweetheart.
sleep will banish sorrow. Tears and parting may make us forlorn, but with the dawn a new day is born. So I'll say good night, sweetheart, though I'm not beside.